Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Gaur Arpit. Today I am here with one more video on prose of 18th century in which I will discuss about Richard Steele, a prose writer of 18th century. Before that, I have already discussed about Jonathan Swift and Daniel Defoe. You can check those videos. And in my description box, I have given links of my ebooks that are available on Kindle and Amazon, and my third book on English literature is going to be published within one or two days, and the topic of my third ebook is William Shakespeare, a great dramatist. I hope you will also show your love for my books also, and along with this, let us start our today's topic, that is Richard Steele. For the first time in 18th century, we come across a huge mass of pamphlets, journals, booklets, magazines, etc. And much of 18th century prose is taken up by topical journalistic issues. The novel and the periodical papers were the two genres that were introduced in 18th century. And we will discuss about the prose writer Richard Steele, whose time period is 1672 to 1729, who is known for his periodical The Tatler. So let us start. Steele was one of the most active and prominent men of letters in the reign of Queen Anne. He was an Irish writer, playwright and politician. He was born in a family of the English burning class in Ireland. He is described as an Englishman born in Ireland. He was educated at Charterhouse, where he met his famous friend and collaborator Joseph Addison. By nature, Steele was genial, impulsive and good-natured. He always did that which appealed more strongly to his inclinations. He is also remembered as co-founder of the magazine The Spectator with his friend Joseph Addison. He became the favorite secretary of his colonel Lord Cutts, to whom he dedicated The Procession. The Procession is a poem which was written on the funeral of Queen Mary. He brought his own experiences of his life to his essays. He was also a moralist. In 1707, he was appointed as an editor to official organ of the government, the London Gazette. He took part in politics and was chosen as the main journalist of the Whigs in opposition. Talking about his dramatic works, The Tender Husband, the best of his plays, time period is 1705. By 1707, Steele became the gazetteer, the writer of the official government newspaper. He left his army job, and profit from his work, The Tender Husband, was meager. The only thing he wrote between The Tender Husband and his appointment as gazetteer were a prologue for Sir John Vanbrugh's play, that is The Mistake, and prologue to the University of Oxford, 1706. After a long period, in 1712, he wrote about a prologue to Philip's The Distressed Mother. After the accession of George I, he obtained a number of political favors. In 1715, he was re-elected to Parliament, and in 1716, he came with a prologue to Addison's The Drummer. Then in 1723, we have his last and most successful comedy, named as The Conscious Lovers. And then we have another works like The Tatler, The Spectator, The Guardian, The Reader, The Englishman, Town Talk, The Spinster, The Plebeian. These are some, we can say, short-lived periodicals like The Reader, Town Talk and Plebeian, which have, these have more matter related to politics, right? Then Steele launched his own paper, The Tatler, three times weekly. It was a joint venture of Steele and Joseph Addison. Both men were Whigs and sympathized with the moral attitudes of England's rapidly growing middle class. The first issue of The Tatler's brilliant successor, The Spectator, that appeared in 1711. The Spectator was partly a newspaper and partly a journal of politics and of society events. Later on, essays on general questions of manners, morality and entertainment were also included. The great majority of The Tatler issues were authored by Steele. Their literary partnership of Joseph Addison and Richard Steele, ranked as one of the most successful in the history of English literature. These periodicals, The Tatler and The Spectator, established for Richard Steele a second and more permanent reputation. His papers have sincerity, frankness and genuine autobiographical touches. In the short span of 4 years in which Addison and Steele worked together, the periodical essay was established as one of the most important forms of literature. and the literary magazine won its place as an expression of the social life of the nation. Richard Steele was not the inventor of the English essay in real sense. There were other essayists of 18th century such as Collier and Temple, but he was the first to use these essays for periodical purposes. Both Richard Steele and Joseph Addison together developed a distinct species to which they gave a permanent character and which they had many imitators. Addison contributed some 46 papers and collaborated in several others, but most of these were written by Steele himself, both as man and as writer. Richard Steele is one of the most attractive figures of his time. Much of his writings are deeply sincere and reflects his personality. As George Berkeley, who is his contemporary and philosopher, he said, "There appears in his natural temper something very generous and a great benevolence to mankind." And our favorite Richard Steele died in 1729 because of paralytic stroke. So friends, this is all about Richard Steele. I hope you will like my content, and if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel, and if you are new on my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications from my upcoming videos also. And thanks a lot for watching.